I don't care what anybody says. Whether you're a hip-hop head, a fucking pop head, a metal head, a death metal head, no music head, you will have once been a fan of Eminem. And if you haven't, you will have known Eminem, because guys, Eminem is this legendary character in the music industry who has touched a lot of people's hearts and insulted a lot of people along the way. Guys, Eminem yesterday released a new fucking, in fact, not even a song, an entire album. An entire album. One album has pretty much just like fucking like everyone has just been. Guys, today is a bit of a legendary day, guys. A legend in the music industry. Whether you're a hip-hop head, a metal head, a pop head, a no music listening head, you will have once been a fan of Mr. Marshall motherfucking Mathers, guys. Yes, Eminem has just released not even one new song, an entire freaking album. He surprised us all. I was shocked, to say the least. Now, I have not, in fact, you know what we're going to do? We're going to check out Eminem's entire discography, because it got to a point where I think everyone, not even me, but just everyone, stopped listening to Eminem, really. Well, not everyone, but most people. So I stopped listening to Eminem, and I think maybe most of the people that I know will have stopped listening to him at around this time. But around the Encore album, released in 2004, that's kind of when I stopped listening to him. Relapse, couldn't name one song off of that album. Recovery, The Marshall Mathers LP2, or Revival. Didn't listen to anything. But people have been going insane over the Kamikaze album. So that was released August 31st, yesterday, 2018. So one song, I think it's Kamikaze that everyone is kind of going apeshit over, is the one that we're going to be doing today, guys. So what we're going to do is we're going to get Kamikaze, the song, and we're going to listen to that and we're going to react to it. I am stoked because I haven't listened to it yet and everyone has been just going apeshit over this shit, okay? So Kamikaze, we got it here. Got it here. So guys, this is 3 minutes 35 seconds long. The lyrics are here, but I'm going to try and see if there's any lyrics on Lyric Genius. So yeah, this is, I think, the first album in a while that he's collaborated with Dr. Dre on. So, man, I don't know what he's going to try and go for here. I don't know. He seems to be trying to go with back to his like old self, but then it just doesn't happen. I don't know, man. I've been very disappointed, though, with like the few new stuff that I listened to by him. Eminem, Kamikaze lyrics. Lyrics Genius. Yes, we do. Guys, let's rock and roll. Before I get into this, though, if you're new to watching this fucking channel, make sure you subscribe. Yes, I am a rap head who listens to a lot of metal, but every now and then, I will go back to my fucking hip-hop music and react to the shit, for example, today. So yeah, guys, make sure you subscribe to this channel and click that notification bell button so you guys know my next reaction video is out. Guys, click that thumbs up button because it really helps get my channel, you know, to a larger audience, because I'm very, very eager to hit 6K subscribers and we are very close. So without further ado, everybody, Eminem, Kamikaze. The way I do these reaction videos, if you're new here, is I listen to the entire song, and then once the song is done, we review the crap out of this song. So, let's rock and roll. 3 minutes, 35 seconds long.
Okay. How do I say this? Last year didn't work out so well for me. 2018. Well,
yeah, I'm a fucking kamikaze crashing into everything. You beat me, Islamic Nazi, that means there is no such thing. I've been going for your juggler since Craig G. Duck Alert. Wedgie in my underwear, the whole bedsheet in the comforter. Stuck up in my rectal crack, kiss my disrespectful ass. I ride through your
window, crack open your reference
tracks. You collaborative effort rap. I have never said his raps. Overstayed my welcome, stepped in crap and ruined your welcome mat. So spit that shit from the heart, you didn't write like you wrote it. Well, I teabag the microphone, cause I go nuts on it. Like a fighter jet line with explosives that'll strike any moment, headed right at opponents. And I'm the fucking pilot that flown it, I'm about to smash.
This fucking flow.
Crash into everything. Back, and I've just begun. Back, 2017.
This fucking flow, dude.
Back on everyone. Back on everyone.
Come on, come on, how's it gonna smash?
Everyone
crash
like an F-15. Damage already done. Y'all should've let me be. Back on everyone. Back on everyone. Back on everyone.
I turned to rap cause it made me feel tough when I wasn't. From the moment I heard rappers cussing, I wasn't. Which is why I identify with the guy who I was invented by. Dre's Frankenstein energized like a 9-volt. Ice cold like snake eyes, twice in a row on a dice roll. But if the only reason I blowed is cause I'm white, though why don't every other white rapper sell what I sold? Kamikaze pilot, I wrote my suicide note. Here come the guys in white coats trying to stop me before I jump behind the controls and try to fly in the phones. Cause I'm taking y'all with me when I go cyclone. I don't think this typhoon's letting up anytime soon. Here I go, eyes closed, blindfolded, I'm about to
smash into everyone,
crash
into everything.
Back,
and I've just begun.
Back,
2017.
Back on everyone.
Back on everyone.
Back on everyone.
Come on,
how's it gonna smash
into everyone,
crash
like an F-15.
Damage already done.
Y'all should've let me be.
Back on everyone.
Back on everyone.
Back on everyone.
Come on,
how's it gonna smash?
Freestyle on Shape 45, that shit was embarrassing. There is no way we ever air that shit again, I guarantee that. Wait, that shit was so ass, it's something we wouldn't dare re-air. Shit's embarrassing, it's me rearing terror, repair. In my therapy chair, my dick is the hair length of Cher. Each nut is the chair with the Vinaquin sale. If beware me, lyrically I'm terrible. Better get your lyrics prepared, Richard Ramirez is here. Serial killing every beat there is it. Wait, wait. Got the eeriest feeling something evil is lurking. I'm no conspiracy theorist, but something here is afoot. Oh yes, my dick, get the measuring stick.
What?
12 inches of wood, wait. But I've been going for your juggler since Craig G. Duck Alert. And I've come to pay respects, cause if you sleep, you're fucked. Other words, you get laid to rest. And I hope your butt is hurt. Put me on a track, I go play on it like a color book. You got some views, but you're still below me. Mine are higher, so when you compare our views, you get overlooked. And I don't say the hook unless I wrote the hook. And now I'm just freestyling in the vocal booth. And you know I've always spoke the truth. You're lying through your teeth so much you broke a tooth. And it ain't something I need a phone to do. When I say I can't wait till I get a hold of you. And I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Light up the rappers, take my pic like a photo shoot.
Fucking hell. Eminem still has this shit. Eminem still fucking has it. Oh my god, dude. I'm fucking, like, I was not expecting that at all. I was not expecting that. Woo! Okay, so Eminem lyrically slays, flows, slays. Dude. Okay. I fucking hate the beat. I think the beat is so weak until the last part where he goes, wait, wait, got the eeriest feeling, something evil is lurking, I'm no conspiracy theorist. So after, like, that bit, that beat is fucking, it's so Kendrick Lamar type dark beat. But what the fuck was the beat before that? That is so, that shit was so whack, like, especially at the chorus. I feel like The verse was amazing, but then the chorus is like, it's just so weak, man. It's like, you have the most strongest verse, and I don't know if maybe they were trying to just make the verse the strong point, and then have the chorus as a sort of, kind of, maybe chill part, and then bring the verse back, and then it comes back punchier, but I thought that, you know what, I think they should have made the chorus even bigger. Just even bigger, man. So for me, I think the beat was like fucking whack until the final part, and that's for me where the thing came in. I think the kick should have been thumpier and thicker. I hate that bam 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 bam. That part I don't like at all. But in saying that, Eminem's fucking delivery on this song, hands down, insane. Freaking crazy, dude. He still has it. Oh my God, bro. And I know he's... Look, in my personal opinion, I'm not throwing any shade at my fucking boy Eminem, right? But I personally feel like he won't be able to get what he had in the first three albums, you know, when he first started. I personally don't think so. But he made such a good effort in this song to kind of get the elements of, like, from those old songs. But I just feel like he has so much hate in himself and he's trying way too hard. Whereas his old stuff is just, it's so authentic. He's not trying. It's just how he feels. You know, and I think, I don't know, man. I don't know if it's just, he needs to perhaps maybe just get over that and try something new. You know? I don't know, bro. But in my opinion, I think this song, right? He came back and he kind of successfully tried to get what he had before, like ages ago, you know? And this is a very good way that he did it, like implementation-wise. So let's go through the lyrics. I'm excited, yo. Okay? So, okay, how do I say this? Fact. Last year didn't work out so well for me. 2018? Well, so obviously last year he's referring to like the last album that he released, which I don't know. I didn't even bother listening to it. Apparently it fucking did really bad, like the ratings-wise. Like, people just hated on that shit so much. And also, here's my opinion, okay? Who recorded the last one? Executive produced by Rick Rubin, okay? And the Marshall Mathers LP2, Rick Rubin as well. So with this, it seems like he only... Who did he go with? It was just Dr. Dre and Eminem as executive producers, and I think... Maybe that might be a reason as to why those last two albums just kind of didn't do so well, because of Rick Rubin. Anyways, yeah, I'm a fucking kamikaze crashing into everything. You beat me, Islamic Nazi. That means there is no such thing. I've been going for your jugular since Craig G. Duck alert. Wedgie in my underwear, the whole bed sheet and the comforter stuck up in my rectal crack, kiss my disrespectful ass. I'll read through your cul-de-sac, window crack, bumping your reference tracks. You collaborative effort rap. I have never said his raps, overstayed my welcome, stepped in crap, and ruined your welcome mat. You spit that shit from your heart. You didn't write like you wrote it. While I teabag the microphone, because I go nuts on it. I like that. Like a fighter jet-lined with explosives that'll strike any moment, headed right at opponents, and I'm the fucking pilot that flown it. I'm about to smash into everything, crash into everything. So he's basically saying he's a kamikaze jet, and like he's just gonna fucking just see everyone in the rap industry. He's just gonna fly, smash right through them, and get to the fucking front. I turned to rap because it made me feel tough when I wasn't. From the moment I heard rap was cussing, I was in. Ah, interesting. Which is why I identify with a guy who I was invented by, Dre's Frankenstein. Hey! Energized like a 9-volt ice cold, like snake eyes twice in a row on a dice roll. Motherfucking, this guy's lyricism, dude. But if the only reason I bowed is because I'm white, though, why don't every other white rapper sell what I sold? Ooh. Kamikaze pilot, I wrote my suicide note. Here come the guys in white coats trying to stop me before I jump behind the controls and try to fly into foes, because I'm taking y'all with me when I go cyclone. I don't think this typhoon's letting up anytime soon. Here I go, eyes closed, blindfolded. I'm about to mash into everything, crash into everything. Oh man. Oh, so he fucking knows that he didn't do well in 2017, yo. I heard your freestyle on Shade 45. That shit was embarrassing. Who is he referring to here? There is no way we ever hear that shit again, I guarantee. Let's see, some play on words. He says that the freestyle sounded so bad that his radio station, Shade 45, wouldn't play it again. Who is he referring to, though? That way that shit was so ass, it's something we wouldn't dare re-air. And the shit's embarrassing as me rear-ending Tara Reid Bear. In my therapy chair, my dick is hair. My dick is the hair length of Cher. Each nut is the chair width of an acorn stairlift. Beware of me. Beware of me. Lyrically, I'm terrible. Better get your lyrics prepared. Richard Ramirez is here. Serial killing every beat there is. Okay. So this is the bit now of the song which I fucking loved. Wait, wait, got the eeriest feeling. Ah, so this is now where like the beat changes because you got the eeriest feeling. Something evil is lurking. I'm no conspiracy theorist, but something here is afoot. Oh yeah, it's my dick. Get the measurement stick. 12 inches of wood. Wait, I've been going for your jugular since Craig G. Duck Alert. And I've come to pay respects because if you sleep, you're fucked. Other words, you get laid to rest and I hope your butt is hurt. Put me on a track, I'll go cray on it like a color book. You got some views, but you're still below me. Mine are higher, so when you compare our views, you get overlooked. And I don't say the hook unless I wrote the hook. Guys, he rhymed hook with fucking hook. And he can do that because he's Eminem, okay? And now I'm just freestyling the vocal booth. And you know I've always spoke the truth. You lying through your teeth so much you broke a tooth. Guys, holy shit, he rhymed teeth with tooth. No, he didn't. Truth with tooth. And it ain't saying something I need a phone to do. When I say I can't wait till I get a hold of you. And I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Line up the rappers, take my pick like a photo shoot. Guys, he is just taking the piss out of everything. Eminem does what Eminem does best. Telling people that they fucking suck and he's better than them. That's what I love about Eminem is that he does that shit so well. Man, the guy is confident to the 9 millionth degree, man. I dig this. I just don't like the beat. That's one thing I don't like is the beat. And it sucks because I feel like this is one of those songs I probably won't listen to again, particularly because of the beat. Except for that last part. I really like the last part. Kind of like, you know what it's kind of like? Kendrick Lamar's DNA. I hated, like, is it DNA? Yeah, kind of like Kendrick's DNA, where it's like, you know, the first part of the song I fucking hated, but then 3 minutes in, oh my god, fuck, man. Splice that shit up and just serve me the last part of the song, please. So I feel like this is one of those songs where I'll just fast forward to like the outro part. Which really annoys me because, man, he just... Oh, his wordplay here is just insane. It's honestly like Earl Sweatshirt's fucking wordplay. But anyways, guys, that is my reaction. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Are you a rap head? Do you like metal, but you also like Eminem? Let me know what you guys think about this song in the comment section down below. And guys, I don't know if I should react to just the entire album. Do all the songs from the entire album. This would be interesting, but let's see how it goes, guys. In the meantime, have a great, fantastic, beautiful, wonderful day. Peace. Oh, also, I'm going to give this song like a overall. Okay, I'm going to give it like a 9.5. The beat was a huge letdown, but I'm kind of like... I'm giving that rating based on Eminem's wordplay, lyricism, lyrics, writing, delivery. 9.5. In fact, fuck it, 10, just for that. But with the beat, the fact that the beat was whack probably brings the song down to about like a maybe 7.8 or something. Peace.